Hi, Mr. Vorschauer, this is Emily Griffey from IFMC 1A. Today I will be discussing the impact of electronic banking on customer satisfaction and be comparing both of traditional and electronic banking. Let me start with Bill Gates' quote. Bill Gates at 1990 said that banking is necessary, banks are not. And by this he meant that traditional banking will gradually disappear and electronic banking, which attracts more and more new users, will replace it. And innovations in the banking and financial services space since the arrival of the ATM have proved that Gates was right. So let's pass through the summary. Today we'll have the introduction, the good old days, which are equivalent to the traditional banking days, electronic banking, and on how banks can satisfy their customers through e-banking, and of course the conclusion of the research. So introduction, gone are the days when people had to stand in long queues at the bank just to transfer money or to get account statements. So with banking technologies consistently improving, banking is now more way convenient and quick, and one of the most important elements in our modern world is of banking is of course the electronic banking. So what is electronic banking? What are the different types of e-banking facilities? And let's take a look at some of the most important things every modern consumer should know about electronic banking. So people often reminisce about the good old days, but those times were not that great. Traditional banking is the financial institution that is dedicated to the administration of the money that its clients deposit in custody, while they use it to grant it as a loan to individuals or companies, charging them interest, of course. And a traditional bank has headquarters as well as regional HQs, with branches located across the countries in which it operates. So traditional banks with their local branch were initially chosen for their convenience as well as their face-to-face customer services. So what are the advantages of traditional banking? Although using a traditional bank might seem old school or too conventional, knowing some of the benefits of using traditional bank can help customers decide if it's a good solution for keeping and handling their money. So whether you want a personal savings or checking account, trust fund, certificate of deposit, or business checking account, most major financial institutions can provide all these services in one place. So you have more options, and the leading banks like Chase, Wells Fargo, and Bank of America have brick and mortar locations and ATM, which are free to customers all over the country. So it's convenient. And for banking customers who deal with cash frequently, of course, a traditional bank is always an attractive and convenient option. What are the inconveniences now of e-banking? So although it has been playing an important role in the economy, it remains a major disadvantage of traditional banking, the slowness with which many officials operate when providing customer services, since it always requires human resources to process transactions. We can also add the less of flexibility, availability, little stimulus to savings and commissions for accounts, and the wide range of fees. So electronic banking. Electronic banking uses an electronic medium to help users get access to their funds. It eliminates the need for the bank's customers to visit the bank to do financial transactions. And with more and more new customers now using the internet for a host of their day-to-day activities, this digital medium of banking makes banking more accessible and convenient for users. The different types of e-banking facilities. Internet banking is a type of e-banking service which allows you to do several financial and non-financial transactions through the internet. You can use your laptop and internet connection to use the facility, and most banks now also have an app or mobile banking of the bank. If you use an Android or iOS device, you can download the app of your bank and use the facility. So the app can also be used to transfer in funds, checking account statements, locate the nearest ATMs, and other banking services. We have also debit card and ATMs. So ATM or automatic teller machine is one of the most popular type of electronic banking. It's an electronic computerized telecommunication device which enables you to withdraw or deposit funds, change PIN also, and it eliminates the need of visiting a bank and doing this transaction through a human teller. Debit card, so for the debit card, you might already be using debit cards for many of your daily transactions. And this card is connected to your bank account and you can use the funds from your account directly through this card. Moreover, banks have made sure that all these services are highly convenient and can be easily used by anyone with advanced security systems, protecting all electronic transactions, and be rest assured that all your financial transactions with e-banking are completely safe and secure. E-banking isn't, of course, for everyone. Illiterate and elderly and those without internet connection cannot use online banking, and this is one of the disadvantages of e-banking. And newbies often face difficulty in trying to get the hang of e-banking. Initially, customers are scared of losing their money and often hesitate to explore all the options and features that are available on the website or on the app. We also have fake website and phishing sites are common in this age of technology. And one of the most important disadvantages of e-banking is the financial jargon, and it can often get between the customers and their money. Knowledge is power, and in this case, knowledge is money. So, online banking market overview. The online banking market size is expected to reach 89,976 million in 2023 from 7,305 million in 2017, growing at a CAGR compound annual growth rate of 22.6% from 2017 to 2023. Digital banking includes all kinds of online internet transactions done for various purposes, and it's the incorporation of new technologies to deliver enhanced customer services. Comparison between traditional banking and e-banking. So the presence banks exist physically for serving the customers, while e-banking doesn't require it. And customers can always access their accounts anywhere with a computer and internet connection. So this is a good point for e-banking. Accessibility also, internet banking is available at any time, and it provides 24 hours access. Security, so traditional banking does not encounter e-security threats. So all in all, we found that electronic banking is more convenient for consumers, and it's better to use e-banking than the traditional one. So how can banks satisfy their customers? So service quality has been recognized as a dominant factor in keeping competitive advantage of and sustaining satisfying relationship with customers, and it's one of the factors contributing to customer satisfaction judgment. And service quality in banking website may boost customer satisfaction, because in internet banking a customer can access a variety of financial transactions, and bankers found that e-service quality dimensions like efficiency, interactivity, security, information, ease of use, and contact were the key factors to affect customer satisfaction in the e-banking service. So as a conclusion, the purpose of this study was to determine both of traditional and electronic banking, to compare them and to examine the relationship between the dimensions of e-banking service quality and customers. And the findings show that reliability, efficiency, ease of use, responsiveness, communication, security, and privacy all have a significant impact on customer satisfaction. And with reliability being the dimension with the strongest impact, e-banking has become one of the essential banking services that can, if properly implemented, increase customer satisfaction and give banks a competitive advantage.